Welcome to Let's Football Live, the podcast featuring candid conversations and inside stories from players, coaches, experts, and pretty much anyone associated with the Hero Indian Super League. On this episode, we have Odisha FC's three captains for the season, Hector Rodas, Vineet Rai, and Victor Mongil. Now, right, captains, my name is Suyash, and I am so excited to explore the themes of leadership, your approach to how that fits in with your own duties on the pitch and the upcoming season. I'm sure it will be fascinating for everyone listening in as well, but we'll get to the heavier stuff in a bit. First up, I just wanted to ask, how's your stay in Goa been so far? Hector, why don't you go for that first?
Yes, I'm feeling good. It's true that it's difficult for me because I have the family in Spain, Lima's experience without my family, but I feel really good here. We have a good team. We have a good person that is important because we stay here 5 months, 6 months, and we have to be a family. And I'm happy to stay here.
Yeah, absolutely. Victor, you know the surroundings a little better than Hector, having spent half a season playing for erstwhile ATK FC in the 2019-20 season of the Hero ISL, and you ended that season as a champion. So firstly, how does it feel being back playing in India after spending last season back in Georgia with Dinamo Tbilisi again? We missed you.
Yes, me too. Hopefully this season repeat the same season, but yes, I come back. But also this year is new for me. The another season, no stay in the bubble and in the situation. But now we have a little family here, and it's more easy the situation with everybody. And yes, I repeat, hopefully we have the same final and win also, but step by step, now is the time for growing up of the team and learn is the best lesson in this season.
Yeah. You mentioned family. We've been watching the videos that the Odisha FC media team has been posting across socials, and the team looks like such a tightly knit bunch. So we're living vicariously through that. Almost makes you want to be a part of that unit. The vibe just looks so good in Odisha FC at the moment. Vineet, if I could come to you now, this is going to be your third season with Odisha FC. You know the club well. And this season, you've been chosen as one of the three captains for the season. It's a theme that we're going to be exploring a bit more in detail going forward. But tell us about your first reaction after you found out, and what was the entire process like? Can you please describe it for us?
Yeah, sure. It's my third season with Odisha FC, and I have been chosen one of the three captains. So first of all, like me, Hector, and Victor, we already said some words after getting selected. I'm so thankful and grateful to guys. They have shown trust on me, Victor, and Hector, on three of us, you know. So new this thing, new experience for me, being the captain of the one of the three captains of the team. So I'm really excited, you know, and looking forward to the seasons, you know, and whatever it takes, you know, we are all ready to. We are working hard, and we are all ready to give whatever it takes to make this season the best one for us.
Yeah,
and we just can't wait to, you know, start the season on 24th of November against Bengaluru.
Yeah, even though the season hasn't actually started, Vineet, have you enjoyed captaincy so far? From whatever little you've sampled of it in pre-season, are you already feeling like a leader?
Yeah, it's a new thing. But last year I did captain in the last game of the season, but this year, in the friendly games, I have been getting some of that vibe again. But putting that armband, it just shows that it gives you an extra responsibility on your shoulders. But if you generally play on the pitch, everyone is the leader of their own role in the pitch, you know. So it's just the band that separates you from others, like to be the captain of the team. But if you in general, everyone is the leader of their own life, and on the pitch they have to decide their own, you know, they have to take their own decisions on the pitch. So yeah, it's exciting for me. It's a new one, but I'm trying my best to, and I'm trying to do my best, you know, to play at my best at this season and help our team to reach final, and everything goes in our own way, then claim the title.
Yeah, you're so right, Vineet, because one necessarily doesn't need the armband to be a captain and a leader on the pitch. But the fact that all three of you now will be wearing it at different points of time during the season, I'm sure that sense of responsibility does seep in at some point of time. Quick question for you, Vineet. I'm going to put you on the spot. Okay, are you ready?
Yeah.
Yeah? Okay. You have played against your fellow captain, Victor Mongeal, before. Can you tell me where that match was played and what the score was?
I think we have lost against him in Kolkata. I think.
Okay, so that's one part of the question that you've answered right. Do you remember the score?
I think it was 3-0 maybe.
3-1, of course.
3-1.
Manuel Onwo scored the goal for Odisha FC that day. But why I bring it up is because Victor Mongeal was actually playing in defense that day. And it was your first opportunity to see what he was like from close quarters. So, Victor, do you remember anything about that game and playing against Vineet?
Of course. Sorry, Vineet. Yes, I remember.
So, have you spoken to Vineet about that game yet?
Yes, it's 3-1, yes. in our stadium.
But Victor was quite fat that time, but now he's very lean. So, I couldn't recognize him when I first saw him.
Okay, it's nice to see that the banter doesn't just extend to captains and people who aren't captains, but within the captains as well. So that's quite nice to see. It's refreshing. But sharp on that one, Vineet. Well done. Now, I'm going to amble across to you now, Victor. You remember playing that game against Odisha FC, and of course, you were in defense when you won 3-1. What was the first thing that you observed about Vineet Rai on the pitch playing for Odisha FC that day, his first season? Do you feel that he's grown as a player in the three seasons? And what do you feel his best qualities are as a teammate and as fellow captain?
Yeah, about the game, no? Against Odisha, the first. I remember this game is when I play in ATK, it's very important for ATK because stay in the top. In the top four, in the top three, about the playoff, in the finals, and if win this game, I remember staying second position or qualify automatically in the playoff. I don't remember exactly, but this game is very, very hard for us because it's only the game. It's also too much pressure in the shoulders, no, about the situation of the ATK and qualify.
Yeah.
And I remember also good players in Odisha, Vineet, also Onu in the striker, Carlos Delgado in the
correct
defender.
Correct. Yeah.
Yes. I remember somebody.
Yeah.
It's a very lucky for me and when play against Odisha.
Yeah, I'm sure Vineet would be glad that Victor, you're on his side now. And Victor, I'm sure you'd feel the same about Vineet.
Yeah, Vineet is a strong player in the middle. It's a muscle, no?
Yeah.
And also this season, he have a good responsibility, no? And it's only captain for responsibility, is also the defend the seal, no? The club, and when everybody need something in only in the pitch, is outside. We need stay one step, no? For everybody and help. And this is important. This is an important leader. And next to me, Vineet about this, and bring Vineet our experience in this situation. And sure, this season we have a good challenge in front.
Yeah. Now, Victor, I also wanted to ask you about fellow Spaniard Hector Rodas. Hector, I'm coming to the topic of you joining the ISL fresh. From Spain this time around. Now, you've had a career in which you've most notably played in the Spanish first and second divisions for clubs like Elche, Real Betis, Levante and Cordoba. So since you have had experience, you know, of playing abroad, what are the discussions you've had about playing in the ISL with Victor and all of the other Spaniards in the squad? I'm sure there's a lot of Spanish going around in the UFC camp with four Spaniards in the squad.
Hi. Yes, for me it's important that the team has too many Spaniards. So it's important for us because we know that it's our football to play with the ball, to press high, and the coach the same. I think it's important that all the players are Spanish in this team. For example, Jonathan played in Spain too. I think we have experience there. And now we have to give this experience to our teammates, young teammates, and try to give the best for them.
Yeah. Hector, there's a picture of yours I came across in which you're squaring up with Francesco Totti. You know, you're almost ready to take him on. Do you remember that moment in that match? What was that all about?
Yes, this match was the day of centenary from Levante. And was a friendly match, but it was a very hard game. And I remember that this game was hard, and Totti was very aggressive with me, and then Adriano, Rossi, and all the players go to find me, and my teammate defend me and close the problem.
Yeah, I mean, Hector, from your perspective, you've had a career playing at a certain level. You've played matches against Real Madrid and Barcelona. So what is the mentality with which you come to the ISL and with which you join Odisha FC? What drives you to come to the ISL?
Well, for me, it was a new opportunity, new experience for me. I want to leave this football, this country. And Kiko and Kino called me for this experience. I think about this. I think for grow up in this country with my teammates, with Odisha. It's a new experience. I play in Spain a lot of years. I play in first division, second division. I get promotions to first division. I play in Belgium, in other country, but never play in ASEAN. Why not? I want to fight in this country, to fight for big teams here, and for me, in a good age, you know, for growing up here. And it's a new experience for me, and I want to enjoy.
Right. We also have Javi Hernandez listening into this Twitter space. So shout out to you, Javi. The Odisha FC fans, I'm sure, can't wait to see what you have lined up your sleeve this season. Of course, going forward, the calm and composed demeanor that you, of course, seem to exude is going to serve Odisha FC, of course, really well throughout the season. But while we're on this topic, we have three captains with us. I'd like to speak a bit about leadership styles, gentlemen. Now, the beauty of leadership is that there's so many different ways of being a leader. So it would be interesting to know what your individual approaches to being a leader and being a captain are. So let's start with you, Vineet. What is your approach to being a captain and a leader?
First of all, I'm very new to this experience. You know, I've been like captain last year in last game, and I've been captain once in under-23, also in for the national team. So, but it's a huge responsibility, you know. I think, and Hector and Victor already has so much experience in these terms, you know, like how to handle the team. But I always follow him. I actually follow what Hector and Victor eats also, you know. I really follow them, and with Javi and all these things, like how they eat, how they take care of their body, you know. So I'm really, really learning from them a lot. So I it's my first experience, as I said. I would love to learn a lot of things from Hector, Javi, Victor, and everyone from other teammates also. But for me, I think most important thing is, like, obviously, like when we win, it's everyone is happy. Everyone talks with everyone very nicely. But the most important thing, like, is when we have the hard times, that's where the leadership shows, you know, the real quality to gather everyone and to push everyone in the dressing room after the game, or when we back to the hotel and when we are doing recovery session next day. So it's about like trying to motivate them, our teammates trying to motivate them and try to focus on the next game, and so that you know, this one match which we lost or which we drew, which we knew like we would have win that, so that should not cost us in our future, you know. So it's like we have to forget and move on. The main leadership role in that is like try to motivate everyone when someone is having a bad game in that match, only in that moment only, like you have to be the one, you know, to cheer them up, come on, let's go, and all these things. So that like a leader should always be someone who pushes their teammates and other players, you know, and to the whole club, you know, so that we all stick together in our good times and bad times. That's the most important thing, I think.
Yeah, Vineet, I can tell you on record, you're already speaking and sounding like a leader. So you've already begun well. Well done on that.
Thank you.
Hector, what about you? What is your approach to leadership? What is your leadership style?
Well, I'm lucky, no, because in other teams, I was captain too. I think I'm a person with a lot of character, you know, so not only experience. I'm a person with character, very competitive. So I try to transmit my values for the other teammates, for the young players, help them. And I think the captain has humility, empathy. He has to be a leadership, you know. And this is important. I think like Vinit told, in the hard moments, you have to push all the people, try to resolve the problems, stay always ready for fight with your teammates. And I think it's important for the team to select good captains. And then I think the most important thing that all the people have to be a leader in this world, you know?
Yeah. And Hector, Victor, it must feel nice that you've been given that trust and been given that responsibility by your own teammates, because both of you are new to the team. And to have that kind of impact straight off the bat and being voted as captain must feel nice, right, Victor?
Yeah, it's too much nice about this. Also, I think in the same, no, with my teammates Vinit and Hector, our job with the captain is help for everybody, is bring our experience for the teammates. I consider myself a leader who does not like to lose, but compete and make my teammates feel my desire for waiting to achieve important things, and also the same helping my teammates inside the pitch and outside in the dress room, in the travels, and the most important is defend the club for one step more with the players, and it's a beautiful responsibility for us, and I think we have a good challenge for in front.
Yeah, but the biggest question, guys, and I'm sure this is something that we've all been wondering about, is how is it going to work? Are you going to rotate captaincy from game to game? Has the manager given you any indication of that? Or if you don't have the answer to that, we can always pick it up with Kiko Ramirez whenever we do run into him next time around. But how is it going to work?
I think it's at the end of the day, like obviously we are like three captains, but it will be decided by the coach, you know, like he's the one who is in charge of everything, or the team and everything, like and we are more than happy, like whoever be the captain, like obviously coach will decide who is the captain or not, but for us, whoever on the pitch, our job is to give our 100% for the team, whether we are wearing that armband or no. But at the end of the day, the things which matters the most is the win and the 3 points, you know. So I think that's the most important, you know, to help our team, to give our best on the pitch every time, whenever we step on the pitch, to give our 100% every time and work hard, and so that our team gets the result what we wanted, you know.
Yeah, I also got the answer I wanted. Basically, it hasn't been spoken about yet, but yes, I expected the same answer. Of course, it all depends on Kiko Ramirez, the manager, to decide who's captain from game on game. And of course, like we established at the start of this Twitter space, that none of you ever need the armband to actually be a leader or be a captain. So that's always there. But talking about Kiko Ramirez, let's just transition a bit into speaking about him and his coaching staff, completely revamped at Odisha FC. Hector, have you enjoyed working under Kiko so far? And what are some of the new philosophies that he's bringing to the team?
Yes, Kiko is a very close coach. You know, he talks with all the players. He always say that they want to transmit to the players. And he tried in the first days to make a good tactical, a good that the people take good decisions. And it's not easy because we are a new team, new players, very young players, no? But the good thing that Kiko has is with very patience with the young people, with the new people. And I think a very good coach because understand all the situation and always try to help all the people. So I'm really happy to work with him, and he trusts to me, and it's so important for me.
Yeah. And gentlemen, talking about leadership, while you three are leaders, Kiko Ramirez is so to speak, your leader. And I've always found it fascinating how some of the best leaders in men's football are one with the team. They're sometimes one of the boys, but yet command that respect. If I may use that term, maintain that power distance. So how is Kiko Ramirez when training sessions aren't on, Vineet? Is he someone who comes and gels with the boys and speaks with them like a friend, or is he more of a father figure?
Yeah, I think first of all, he's a very good human being, I think, because he's very hard on the pitch with everyone, you know, because he wants everyone to push. He likes to push everyone so that everyone pulls their 100% in every training session. And I think he's a very fair guy, I think, because for him, the philosophy is whoever will work hard, he will play on the pitch. So for him, the simple philosophy is like hard work. But and yeah, gelling with the team in the off days or something like that, he gels with us, with Indian players and other players. But the problem is he's a communication, no? He cannot speak English fluently like us. But then also by his expression, we feel he gives smiles at us. How much ever he can speak, he try to speak with us. And sometimes he asks us are you okay or no, how are you feeling after training. So it's kind of good because it feels good when your head coach is taking care of you guys and he's trying to gel with you guys in the off days, and whenever he looks at you, he says morning, good evening. It's kind of it makes you feel good. But the problem only is that he has the communication gap between us because he has this English problem. But even though he tries his best to gel with us how much ever he can.
Yeah. And these are working functions that, of course, get ironed out during the course of the season. So I'm sure that that's going to be taken care of as the season progresses. And Vineet, you spoke about smiles and how he flashes you a smile and he likes checking up on people. There have been a lot of smiles around the Odisha FC camp. And I'll come back to the videos that have been posted. The mood in the camp seems extremely positive. So, Vineet, I'll come to you first, and then Victor, and then Hector. I want to ask you, who are the biggest characters in the dressing room? The kind who will basically ensure there's never a dull moment around them.
Usually, we all are very comfortable with each other, you know, whenever we all are very comfortable with each other. We wish each other not only good morning, good evening, even though when we are having food, whenever Hector, Victor, Javi or other foreigners or whoever comes, they say just bon appetit or something like that. So it's we are more of a family, you know.
Yeah.
So and it's very good, you know, we always joke with each other, and whatever problem we are facing, we go and speak and we try to solve it, you know. So we are more than family at the moment, because even though we are far away from our family and foreigners are way far away from the family and we are in the bubble, but we are, you know, these things caring each other, having a laugh with each other makes you feel like home, you know. So, and that's the most important thing at the moment. And I think we have a great team and great bonding with each other. So we can't just wait to start the season and do something big.
Yeah, Vineet, I'll put you on the spot. Are Victor and Hector funny characters?
Victor and Hector?
Yes.
both are funny. Like you know, Hector also sometimes in training also we have so many fun. Like when we when something bloopers happens, you know, something. So we always make fun or something. It's good. Like both of them are funny, and everyone we try to make is laugh like another person, you know. So
yeah, like I said. The videos are enough, Vinit. The videos are enough.
You can see in social media the videos and all these things. Yeah, like we try to mess around with each other, you know, so that we can make a smile or we have a good time with each other.
Now, I want to pose the next question to you, Victor first and then Hector. Since both of you are new to the club and Vinit has been around for a couple of years, which Indian players have impressed you the most and who do you feel has the potential to have a big season? Which Indian player, Victor?
We have very interesting players, Indian players in our team. The most important also is everybody want to learn about everything in the trainings and in the games. Too much players play in national team another levels and in the maximum team in the Indian, no?
Yeah.
And I think, for example, I'm staying in another team, no? In India, in ATK. And I repeat too much times in another interviews and meetings. We have a stronger Indian players, good quality, faster, and the most important is good feeling about no angry, learn, humility, yeah. Always work hard, very hard, and this is, I think, is the most important, no, for growing up this season and also in the careers. Sure, this year, have a big surprise in this season, because I think the Odisha this year we can make a big objectives, but always step by step.
Yeah. Hector, what about you? Anyone who's caught your eye? Any Indian player?
Yes, I have been surprised by many Indian players. They are eager to learn and grow. But a young player I really like is Deven. He's 19 years old. He's young.
Deven Son.
Yes, eager to learn and has many many good things. But in general, I think they have a good future and we are going to help them achieve great things in football. So I'm really surprised, and now I have to be for all my best to win my experience and these players achieve good things in football India, and if it's possible, maybe go to Europe.
Yeah, and I'm sure He would love the fact that you said this about him, and all the Indian players, in fact, can of course grow a lot under your tutelage. They're in good hands, and they have you to look up to as examples. So I'm sure that that'll work out fine during the course of the season and beyond as well. But I can tell you, Odisha FC fans are expecting big things from the foreigners as well. Of course, Hector Rodas and Victor Mongil are there, but all the other foreign signings as well, be it Javi Hernandez, who's listening to this Twitter space, Aridai Cabrera, or Liridon Kazniki as well. But there's such a buzz around Brazilian forward Jonathan, isn't there? And he's not even out of quarantine yet. So, Vinit, what do you think Jonathan is going to add to your team?
I think he's a very important player for us, you know. Like, to be honest, he's the very most important player, I think. Because as I have never played against him, or I have never seen him play in ISL or in any this thing. But as I have heard from Hector and Victor and Javi and all these players, they really like, they are like saying he's a very good player. And I, you know, by listening to this, it gives you know, extra kind of confidence that you have a, you know, striker who really gonna make things happen for you this season, you know, and who's gonna score and make you win games. So, and that's what we need this season, you know, the one who decides the game, you know. And I think Jonathan is a very, very, very good player, and I think he's gonna help a lot to us. And I'm looking forward to learn lots of things from him, you know. And just can't wait for him to get out of quarantine and play some.
Go up against him in training as well, yeah.
Yeah, that's what.
I mean, that's great. And for that matter, even Aridai Cabrera, Victor and Hector, He's someone who's come in with a lot of expectations. So what did the both of you know about Aridai before he joined? And in the time that you've been training together, what have you observed about Aridai? Hector, if you want to go first.
Yes, Aridai for me is a different player. He has a lot of quality, his electricity, he has a goal also. So I think it's important for us, because maybe in these matches that the people don't play well or don't arrive to the area, he take the ball and maybe put an individual play and make a goal or make a good pass. So for us it's very important. Now he try to get the best performance, and I'm sure that he will do a good season.
Yeah. Victor, what about you? Had you heard about Aridai before he joined Odisha FC?
Aridai speaks English perfect. No, he's a joking. No, Aridai is the typical player with the one game is too much close, no? About we can't play good or something. When he receives the ball, he's very dangerous because he's a very quickly player, good quality, also he have a strong shoot and also in the set pitches. And this is the determinant player, no? When the one game is the equivalence and maybe draw, when he receive the ball, always he have a surprise in these games.
Yeah, again, sure, that'll be music to the ears of Odisha FC fans. And in general, the team is just shaping up really well. There seems to be a good balance about the team as well. And with so many new faces in the Odisha FC squad, with a new manager, there's a hunger to improve on last season's campaign. I'm sure it'll be a good season this time around. But Vineet, since you were here last season and you went through the motions of the season that was with Odisha FC, of course, it was disappointing, I'm sure, on a personal level and as a team. What do you think Odisha FC will do differently this season?
Yeah, obviously last season, like, nobody wants to finish the season like that. You know, we finished at the bottom of the table, but it's a part of football and you have to accept that as a professional. But this season, you know, we started very freshly. We started very early pre-seasons, you know, and we have played so many games in Goa, and we have some more games to play ahead in our incoming days. So, and the atmosphere has been really good, you know, like everyone is gelling up with each other very well. We are like, as I said before, we are like very close to each other, like brothers, you know. So we always, whenever we sit for lunch or dinner on the pitch, whenever we are stretching or even on the playing time, we have fun, we smile, we make jokes or something like that. So I think the most important thing for us is like, we are very, very, very like, you know, comfortable with each other, you know, and that atmosphere, that positivity, you know, that and the way the coach pushes us to put effort in every training session and in every match, because he don't want us to take anything, any training session or any match, to take it like very lightly. So whatever he's like, he's every time he's there to push us, and he's a very, very, very fair guy. And whoever works hard, as you said before, whoever will work hard, and he will play them. So I think that's a very good thing, because it's gonna push not only me or other players also to work more harder, you know, so that you are the one to be on the lineup, you know. So for that, I have to work hard, I know, and everyone and every other player knows that. So the more that's why, like, we are very. The positivity and the atmosphere in the team is very good at the moment. I think we're gonna achieve something big this season.
Yeah, that's great insight, Vineet. And to everyone listening, we've had a fascinating chat with Victor Mongil, Vineet Ryan, Hector Rodas so far. Their commitment to the cause on this Twitter space, second to none. Guys, go and continue your recovery after yesterday's preseason match, captains. I just want each one of you to speak about what your personal goals for the season are and what your message for the Odisha FC faithful juggernauts is. They're listening in, by the way. So, Victor, let's start with you. Your personal goals for the season and your message to the fans.
Yes. For me, the first message for the Odisha fans, juggernauts, and in general, is support us, because sure, this season we have good moments, and hopefully less bad, also bad moments. And the most important for the projects and for the good performance is stay together, also fans and team, and also club, of course. Everybody give the maximum in the pitch for everybody, and the most important, I repeat, is this stay together, because the season is too much long. Also, it's the strength, no? We are inside the bubble. We can't move outside and disconnect. No, it's only we only focused in the trainers and in the games, and this is all for me and also for my teammates. Give the maximum in the pitch, and hopefully we have a good performance this season.
And Victor, I don't know quite what I can ask you going forward about your personal goals, because you're going to be playing either in defense or in midfield. So do you have a target for a number of clean sheets that you're aiming for this season, or are you aiming for a certain number of goals this season?
Yeah.
Any clean sheets coming your way? Do you have a target?
Yeah, the coach decide about this. I'm comfortable in the central defender and also in midfield. Yeah. In ESL, I was playing in defender midfielder in another season, and I'm comfortable in both positions. Normally in Spain I play too much games in central defender. For me, doesn't matter. The most important when I play, I give all my best, and after the coach decide, I play in the central defender or defensive midfielder.
Yeah, I guess we'll find out when the season starts. Vineet, what about you? Your message to the fans and your personal goals for the season?
First of all, I want to thank everyone for sticking with us here in the spaces, Twitter spaces. And I just want to say the way they show love and support to us, you know, in every time. So it's quite amazing, and it makes you feel so good, you know. I just want them to stick with us throughout the season. You know what? Obviously, we are working hard. We have so many goals, team goals, personal goals. But we don't know what future holds for us. But so there are gonna be good times. There are gonna be bad times. But I just want them to keep supporting us, keep loving us, and keep praying for us. You know, so that we all like. Or the Juggernauts FC fan, or Odisha fans, you know, and you know, they all stick with us, and you know, sticking with that's the most important thing, you know, to stick with each other in good times and bad times. So I just want them to keep supporting us the way they are doing, and we can only assure that thing, like, we're gonna work hard and we're gonna do whatever it takes to make all the Odisha FC people and the fans of Odisha to make them proud, you know. And And as for the personal goals, you know, to be honest, for me, it's going to sound quite strange, but I don't have at the moment any personal goal or something. But for me, the most important thing this season is I just want team to succeed, you know, this season. And for that, I have only one thing, that I have to work hard in every training session and in every match, so that whenever I step on the pitch on 24th or after that in any game, you know, I can assure you that you know, I just gonna give my everything on the pitch, you know. I'm gonna work hard and do my best to make the team win, you know, to make the team win, because at the end of the day, if the team wins, everything goes well, everything comes to your way, you know. So I just want my team to win and achieve to finish in the playoff, and then after playoff we'll see, like, we will try to go to the finals, and in the finals we'll try to claim the title. So for me, the most important thing this season is the team wins, you know. That's it.
Yeah, and there's no harm in not having personal goals, Vineet. It just means that you align your goals more with the team, which is what it's all about, isn't it, at the end of the day?
Yeah, that's true, because when team wins, so all the good things come to your way, you know. So the most important for me at this season is, like, I just want our team to prove, you know, since the day I joined, I've never been to the playoffs. So this year I just want to dedicate myself to the team, you know, so the team gets the result what they want, and I'm gonna assure that I'm gonna give all my best, and I'm gonna try to push all the team, all my teammates also to do their best, so that everyone, each and every individual, can give their best and help the team to achieve their team goals.
Yeah, that sounds great and so motivating, even to a listener, Vineet, not just to, I'm sure how it would be to the Odisha FC players listening to this, but even as a listener, just very, very motivating to hear that. Finally, I'll come to the newest addition to the Indian football ecosystem, Hector. What about you? Your personal goal for the season and your message for the Odisha FC fans?
Well, my personal goal is always to help my team. I want to do the best on the pitch and help the club grow and have a great season. It's just saying that we can now enjoy them with the fans, but I will surely feel them close by. I will give everything to make them feel proud of us. All the goals, and maybe I can score some goals better, you know. But I think maybe in the set pieces I can score. But the first always is the team is try to help my teammates, and I'm sure that the results and the good feel are right.
Yep, we're looking forward to seeing you go up for those corners and maybe connect with a few of your towering headers and seeing the ball nestle into the back of the net, Hector. But that's a wonderful way to sum it up. Thank you once again, Victor, Hector and Vineet. Wishing you and the team the very best for the season ahead.
Thank you so much, brother, for hosting us. Thank you so much.
Pleasure. Thank you so much, mate.
Pleasure all mine. And to all of you who tuned into this Twitter space, thank you for your company. We hope that you gained more of an insight into Odisha FC and their plans for the upcoming season as we build up to the Hero ISL 2021-22 season, and hearing it straight from the three captains. So until next time, we wish you a very, very happy festive season. It's goodbye from us at Let's Football Live. Stay safe.